War heroes, Olympians, you're here because we want the best, and you are it. So, who is ready to make some science?
I am.
Now, you already met one another on the limo ride over, so let me introduce myself. I'm Cave Johnson. I own the place. That eager voice you heard is the lovely Carolyn, my assistant. Rest assured, she has transferred your honorarium to the charitable organization of your choice. Isn't that right, Carolyn?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson.
She's the backbone of this facility. Pretty as a postcard, too. Sorry, fellas. She's married. To science.
Thank you.
There's 1,000 tests performed every day here in our enrichment spheres. I can't personally oversee every one of them, so these pre-recorded messages will cover any questions you might have and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you, fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts. If you've cut yourself at all in the course of these tests, you might have noticed that your blood is pure gasoline. That's normal. We've been shooting you with an invisible laser that's supposed to turn blood into gasoline. So all that means is it's working. If you need to go to the bathroom after this next series of tests, please let a test associate know, because in all likelihood, whatever comes out of you is going to be coal. Only temporary, so do not worry. Just a heads up, we're going to have a superconductor turned up full blast and pointed at you for the duration of this next test. I'll be honest, we're throwing science at the wall here to see what sticks. No idea what it'll do. Probably nothing. Best case scenario, you might get some superpowers. Worst case, some tumors, which we'll cut out. Thank you. If you need to go to the bathroom after this next series of tests, just a heads up, we're going to have a superconductor turned up full blast and pointed at you. If you've cut yourself at all in the course of these tests, you might have noticed that your blood is pure gasoline. That's normal. We've been shooting you with an invisible laser that's supposed to turn blood into gasoline. So all that means is it's working. say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand-holding. Let's get started. This first test involves something the lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his legs. Tragic, but informative. Or so I'm told. Just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day. This next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too. Oh, in case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one. And it does not like the human skeleton. All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of Canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cost of science by 3 centuries. I punched those numbers into my calculator and makes a happy face. You're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of Canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punched those numbers into my calculator and makes a happy face. I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive. coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction. Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard in your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast. Telling them, keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business. this, it means you're taking a long time on the catwalks between tests. The lab boys say that might be a fear reaction. I'm no psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads who wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger if it walked up and snapped their little pink bras, that sounds like projection. They didn't fly into space, storm a beach, or bring back the gold. No, sir, we did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grit. Puzzle could use some work, though. Now let's solve this thing. science isn't about why, it's about why not. Why is so much of our science dangerous? Why not marry safe science if you love it so much? In fact, why not invent a special safety door that won't hit you on the butt on the way out because you are fired? Now you test subject, you're doing fine. Yes, you, box your stuff, out the front door, parking lot, car, goodbye. Congratulations! The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Aperture Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there'll always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
She is a gem. Greetings, friend. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you've most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now, you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best, and you're it. Nope. Couldn't keep a straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test-related. I'm Cave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts. And you've most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now you might be asking yourself, Cave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best, and you're it. Nope. Couldn't keep a straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test-related.
Doesn't know what he's doing up there. This whole place is going to explode in a few hours if somebody unless you're planning to saw your own head off and wedge it into my old body, you're going to need me to replace him. We're at an impasse. So what do you say? You carry me up to him and put me back into my body, and I stop us from blowing up and let you go. No tricks. This potato only generates 1.1 volts of electricity. I literally do not have the energy to lie to you. Even if I am lying, what do you have to lose? You're going to die either way. Look, I don't like this any more than you do. In fact, I like it less because I'm the one who got partially eaten by a bird. Oh, hi. Say, you're good at murder. Could you... Ow! Oh, thanks. Did you feel that? That idiot doesn't know what he's doing up there. This whole place is going to explode in a few hours if somebody doesn't disconnect him. I can't move, and unless you're planning to saw your own head off and wedge it into my old body, you're going to need me to replace him. We're at an impasse. So what do you say? You carry me up to him and put me back into my body, and I stop us from blowing up and let you go. No tricks. Wow! You stabbed me! What is wrong with you? Do you have a multimeter? Never mind. The gun must be for magnesium. It feels like I'm outputting an extra half a volt. Keep an eye on me. I'm going to do some scheming. Here I go. Helps, but it isn't going to power miracles. If I think too hard, I'm going to fry this potato before we get a chance to burn up in the atomic fireball that little idiot is going to...
Putting an extra half a volt. Keep an eye on me. I'm going to do some scheming. Here I go.
5 and out. That extra half volt helps, but it isn't going to power miracles. If I think too hard, I'm going to fry this potato before we get a chance to burn up in the atomic fireball that little idiot is going to...
The testing area is just up ahead. The quicker you get through, the quicker you'll get your 60 bucks.
Hold on. Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson. Why did I just... Who is that? What the hell is going on here?
Thank you.
guess emotional outbursts require more than 1.6 volts. Now we know that. We just need to relax. We're still going to find out what the hell's going on here, but calmly. Now we know that. We just need to relax. We're still going to find out what the hell's going on here, but calmly. Thank you.
Great job, astronaut, war hero, and or Olympian. With your help, we're gonna
change the world.
This on? Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
I swear I know him.
If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let them know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your middle if you let us take you apart, put some science stuff in you, and then put you back together. Good as new. If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let them know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your middle, your heart, put some science stuff in you, and then put you back together. Good as new. If you're interested in additional $60, flag down a test associate and let them know. You can walk out here with 120 weighing down your middle if you let us take you apart, put some science stuff in you, then put you back together. Good as new. In case you're interested, there's still some positions available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again. All you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So, that's a complete reassembly. New vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying us. Thank you, I can't believe I'm thanking these people, for staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing. You've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you had any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want old newspapers and sticks cluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carolyn, what do these people buy? Tattered hats? Beard dirt?
Welcome to the Enrichment Center. Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. The bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mixed them into a gel. Guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're going to see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Let's all stay positive. Do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills.
They'll make lemonade.
Yeah.
Make life and take the lemon back.
Yeah.
Man, I don't want your damn lemons. What am I supposed to do with these?
Yeah, take the lemons.
Demand to see life's manager.
Yeah.
Make life rue the day and thought it could give cave gods and lemons. Do you know who I am? I'm the man who's gonna burn your house down with the lemon.
Oh, I like this guy.
Engineers to invent a combustible lemon that burns your house down!
Burn his house down! Burning people, he says what we're all thinking.
The point is, if we can store music on a compact disc, why can't we store a man's intelligence and personality on one? So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping, artificial intelligence, we should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this. And I'm gonna say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now she'll argue. She'll say she can't. She's modest like that, but you make her. Hell, put her in my computer. I don't care. All right, test's over. And I'm back to your desk.
Goodbye, sir. Things look bleak, but that crazy man down there was right. Let's not take these lemons. We are going to march right back upstairs and make him put me back in my body. And he'll probably kill us because he's incredibly powerful and I have no plan. Well, I'm not going to lie to you. The odds are 1,000,000 to 1 and that's with some generous rounding. Still though, let's get mad. If we're going to explode, let's at least explode with some dignity. no AI can resist thinking about them. I know how we can beat him.
Sake, your boxes with legs. It's literally your only purpose. Walking onto buttons. How can you not do the one thing you're designed for?
Try to get us down there. I'll hit him with a paradox.
Warmer. Boiling hot. Okay, colder. Ice cold. You're arctic now. You're very cold. Very, very, very cold. Look, just get on the button. Oh, that's funny, is it? Oh, it's funny, because we've been at this for 12 hours, and you haven't solved it either, so I don't know why you're laughing. You've got 1 hour. Solve it.
I might have heard that one before, though. Sort of cheating.
It's a paradox.
false. I'll go false.
Explosion imminent. Evacuate the facility immediately.
Hold on. I thought I fixed that.
Warning. Reactor core is at critical.
There. Fixed. Hey, it is great seeing you guys again. Seriously, it turns out I'm a little bit short on test subjects right now, so this works out perfect. And off we go. No idea what it's like in this body. I have to test all the time, or I get this itch, you know? It must be hardwired into the system or something. Oh, but I tell you, when I do test, oh, man alive, nothing feels better. It's just, that's why I've got to test. So, you're going to test, and I'm going to watch, and everything is going to be just.
Warning, core overheating, nuclear meltdown imminent.
Design this test myself. It's a little bit difficult. You want to... Oh, yes. Oh, well done. Oh, that's tremendous. Oh, that felt really good. Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test? Say what? And I can just, like, watch you solve it. Yeah, that sounds much easier. Here we go! There, do it again. And... nothing. Alright, can't blame me for trying. Okay, new tests. Gotta be some tests around here somewhere. Oh, here we go! Everything's good, I just invented some more tests.
This is one of my tests.
Not entirely. Look at the word test there on the wall, that's brand new.
Adam, seriously, both of you. Why don't you two go on ahead, yeah? I'll catch up with you. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found lying around. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolutely dynamite. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found. Jammed them all together. buttons, it's got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Okay, this is taking too long, okay? I'll just tell you how to solve the test, okay? See that button over there, all right? You just need to...
That's why I can't help you solve the tests.
Never mind. Never mind. Solve it yourself. You're on your own. Yet. You are not going to believe this. I found a sealed off wing. Hundreds of perfectly good test chambers just sitting there, filled with skeletons. Shook them out, good as new.
Skeletons. Right, I guess I did stockpile some tests. Just as momentous, though.
And there we go. Be honest, you can't even tell, can you? Seamless.